students, welcome to NIOS. I'm Dr. Haneet Gandhi, and today we are going to look at measuring weight. How do we measure weight? We all know that from a very young age, children get familiar with the process of weighing objects. For example, they would have experienced weighing of rice, vegetables, groceries, and they know that their school bag is much heavier than their pen, and so on. So they have an experience of measuring weight when they visit to their grocery store, when they help their parents carry poly bags. It's not such an unfamiliar term. But today what we're going to discuss about is how do we measure weight? How do children then move on from these informal ways to more formal ways of measuring weight? We are going to discuss that all measuring activities we know begin from the acts of comparison, leading from non-standard ways of measuring, finally culminating to the standard units of measurement. So the objectives of today's video are to introduce the idea of measuring weight. We will see how weights of different objects can be compared through informal ways, what role do non-standard units play in their measurement, and how can standardized units be used to measure. So let's begin. Let's begin first by a very own understanding of comparing weights. Comparing weights is not a difficult exercise, as I just said. And also, suppose you have two very contrasting objects, it's very easy to compare weights. For example, I have this watch in my hand. I keep this in my hand and a little pen drive. And I ask you to tell me which is heavier. It's not difficult to say that, of course, the watch would be heavier and the pen drive is much lighter. So all these intuitive comparison is very easy to make. Let's see what we could do with our children. Let me show you an exercise here. Ask a grade 4 child to guess the weight of her bag. Most likely, she will request you for a weighing scale to do so. She will probably place the bag on the scale and read out the readings to you. Reading scale is the most convenient way of telling the weight. But this may not define a complete understanding of the concept. How do you know that the girl who is reading aloud from the weighing scale has actually grasped the meaning of weight? So to know how she's grappling with this idea of weight, we need to do several things. And in this video, we are going to do exactly all those. Often we know that children who depict reading from a weighing scale may not have a good understanding of weight. Children may depict a very limited understanding of weight when they just step onto the weighing machine and they read out the scale. That's not a correct way. We will not even come to know whether they've understood the idea of weight or not. We need to go deeper into their understanding. So how do we weigh? How do we measure it? Comparing gives the first-hand experience of any measurement property. Children should be asked to compare and order objects based on their heaviness. Gradually engage them with non-standard measuring activities. And when they've acquired enough acquaintance with the idea of comparing and contrasting weights, expose them to measuring objects with standard units. Some activities that will help children to get the idea of comparing weights are: ask children to collect some objects such as toys, fruits, vegetables, etc. What you need to do is, without any facial expression, just place these objects on the table. Ask them to select any two objects and ask them which is heaviest. In order to ascertain their answer, ask them to use a balance scale. I'm not asking you to use a measuring scale which has a digitalized answer, but ask them to use a scale which has two pans, which is actually a balance scale, and ask them to compare their objects. Do their observations match with their findings? Write their findings on the board. Suppose, for example, they say the guava is heavier than the toy card. Please note it down. When they say that train is lighter than the melon, please pen it down in front of them. These words are also very important for them to grasp. Heavier, lighter, which is more difficult to carry and why. These lead on to an understanding. As I just said, comparing objects on a digital scale is very easy. What you need to do is give them a balancing scale. There are different types of scales. Some scales are based on the idea of comparing and some are based on absolute measurement. Comparison is one way which helps in understanding weight properly. So if you've seen your vegetable seller weighing the vegetables, you would have seen that they have two pans in their balance scale. Scale is based on the idea of comparing. That kind of a balance scale is used to compare weights of the object kept on its pan. However, the other kind of a weighing machine, which we often find in our bathrooms, is the one in which we just step on and that gives us an absolute measure of weight. That is based on the idea of gravitational pull that has been exerted by the object kept on it. So just stepping on the weighing scale doesn't help us much in understanding the concept of weight. The most appropriate tool, and the conventional and the traditionally used tool to measure weight, is our old traditional balance pan, which has two pans in it. We're going to discuss that in details. So though is it easy to read weight from an absolute weighing scale, such a scale can never provide an experiential learning of knowing weight. Reading a number on the scale limits the understanding. A balance scale, being based on the idea of comparing weights, provide a lot of opportunities for understanding the process related to weighing and comparing weights. So my humble advice to you is that let children have enough experience on using this balance scale for comparing and measuring scale. This experiential learning goes a long way in building the idea of weight. So do not compromise on this aspect, a very important aspect of weighing, doing the experiential learning. Let them weigh, let them compare, let them explore the world of weighing things. So please give them a balance. How do we do that? Let's discuss that further. Let's do an activity. Children learn a lot of things when they make their own, on their own. Making a balance scale is once an activity in which children get a first-hand experience of weighing things. Let them make it. What you need to do, it's a very simple exercise. What you need to do is provide them with a cup. I've shown a picture of one of balance scales that we did in a class. It's a very simple activity, as you can see. You only need a traditional hanger, which is very easily accessible. You need two containers to place your things in, perhaps two cups, two katoris, two pans, anything which is very light and which does not have a weight of an oat can be used to hang things. Make sure that the thread that you use is equidistant. There should not be any wobbling between the cups that you use. Make sure that when you put it up empty, they all balance, both the pans balance them together. They are at the same height when you pull them up. So this is a handmade, quickly homemade, made probably from trash balance scale, which gives a very quick understanding of balancing weight. Let children make this in the classroom. The next thing that you need to do is on this balance scale, explore them, give them opportunities to place their objects and weigh and see which of them is heavier. Now, you know, children are very, very familiar with a seesaw. They've been doing a lot of play games on seesaw. So they have a traditional idea of what if the weight is heavy, the seesaw would go down. We'll use the same idea. In the balance scale, we place the objects to be compared on its pan and let the pans suspend freely. The pan that lower downs, of course, is the heavier one, isn't it? Let students weigh objects and experience this principle. Ask them to compare what is readily available to them. For example, their pencils, pencil and eraser, pencil box is lunch box, two pencils and one eraser. One pencil and one box, three erasers and a pencil box. Let them compare and see which one of these are heavier. Which goes down when you compare, which doesn't. Now that's a first-hand experience, isn't it, of experiencing weight. Let them verbalize it, what they've learned. Use lot and not vocabulary related to weight to make the idea clear. Children should be encouraged to use balance they have made, and through such activities, they would develop the skills of using the balance properly. They master the mechanics, by the way. When you use the balance, they master the mechanics of properly lifting the balance, putting the weights and objects to be weighed, and keeping the beam horizontal by adjusting the materials being weighed. So what we're trying to do is not just the skill of weighing, not just understanding the concept of weighing, but also their sensory motor skills are developing when they're trying to balance things, when they're trying to put things horizontally. That's a very important exercise for young children to do. Encourage them and do such, engage them in certain activities in classroom. Moving on from non-standard to standard units. By using non-standard unit, we can represent the weight of one object in reference to the weight of the other object. Start with an activity of comparing things like pencils, erasers, pencil box, etc. Ask children to compare the weight of a pencil box and an eraser. For example, how many erasers will balance the weight of a pencil box? How many pencils will balance the weight of a book? Such comparisons will help children to equate weight of one object in reference to the other non-standard object. Now, please take it very carefully. In our cases we've just listed above, eraser and pencil are the non-standard units that are being used to measure the weight of pencil box and book respectively. So in each case, my non-standard unit is changing. I'm using eraser and representing the pencil box in terms of erasers. And I know since the book is heavier, I'm going to balance it with some number of pencils. So my unit here to balance book are pencils. And my answer would be something like this. If one pencil was placed in the left pan of the balance to balance and we had put 13 erasers on the right pan, we can say that weight of a pencil is equal to 13 erasers. Similarly, if 30 pencils could balance my two books, it's very easy for me then to say that weight of two books is same as 30 pencils. Encourage children to represent weights as comparable quantities, such as the weight of the pencil box is same as 13 erasers. On a balance scale, 6 pencils weigh same as 2 erasers. So what I'm saying is, I'm repeating, 1 pencil box is equal to 13 erasers. 2 books are equal to 30 pencils. Pencil is the unit, the non-standard unit, which is representing the books. Gradually, after they have had enough experience with non-standard units, start using standard units. For example, now, since your eraser was the smallest unit, let them balance eraser with some gram weights. Use 1 gram weights because we have an idea that an eraser can be easily measured in grams. So use those small little gram, 1 gram pieces in your classroom. Ask them how many 1 gram weights will balance the eraser. Supposingly, 2 pieces of 1 gram weight balance the weight of an eraser. You could easily say that weight of the eraser is equal to 2 grams. Now what we've done is weighed the eraser with respect to a standard unit, which is grams. When they become well versed with the idea of non-standard units, they will feel free, to have a proper balance and a standard weight. As they grow up, as they mature mathematically, they should be exposed to different types of weighing devices like the spring balance, the electronic weighing machine, machines that weigh very, very small to very, very large weights. Important title now is to read the weighing scale. As we have seen earlier, a weighing scale gives us an absolute and precise measurement of the weight of the object placed on it. On a weighing scale, we have to simply place the object and read its marking. This gives us an absolute measure. We don't have to do anything. So we just have to place the object. We have to only study the scale that shows on the weighing scale. And that's not a very difficult thing. Like, since we are familiar with reading a normal ruler, reading a weighing scale is not a difficult task. Though the idea of measuring remains the same, different scales have different marking patterns. That's an important thing to consider. Most weighing scales have continuous marking. Now, in this section, we will study how the scales are to be read for precise measurement. Observe a weighing machine. You must be having one in your bathroom. Different weighing machines give different ranges of accuracy. The one used in the vegetable market is used to measure vegetables ranging 1 kg to 100 kg. Whereas the one that is used by jewelers has a very, very small range, sometimes only in gram, because they need quite precision. However, I also want to point out here that the weighing machines which are used to load trucks have a very, very large range. They would be ranging from big kgs to quintals probably. So depending on the need, we have different types of weighing machines. Depending on the exactness that is required, depending upon the accuracy that is required, we need different kind of weighing machines. Let us study the most basic one. In this video, we're going to study the most basic one, because with primary children, I feel just an idea of weighing machines is more than enough. And gradually, you may orient your classes as you feel the need to be. Get a weighing machine. You will find that on the machine, there are some big marks with numerals written on them. And in between those two numerals, there are some hashes. Now, these hashes represent partial weights. The big marks represent kilograms and the finer hashes that are used in between are used for reading the grams. We find that between 2 kilogram readings, there are 10 divisions. Each division represents 100 grams. So if your weight is, let's say, 43.6, 43 kgs, 600 grams, your weight on the weighing machine would indicate somewhere between 46 to 47, and on the sixth partition, stand up and experiment. By the way, ask children to stand, let them compare, let them step on their weighing machine. It's a good exercise and helps them keep a track of their health as well. Finally, let's summarize our learning today. From the very young age, children get familiarized with the process of weighing the objects. Comparing gives a first-hand experience of any measurement property. Children should be asked to compare and order objects based on their heaviness. Encourage children with non-standard measurement activities. And when they have acquired enough acquaintance with the idea of comparing and contrasting weights, expose them to measuring objects with standard units. By using standard units, we can represent the weight of one object in reference to the weight of another object. The other object becomes your unit in which your weight has been compared. Children learn a lot when they make things on their own. So encourage a classroom activity of making a balance. This balance activity is one such through which children get a first-hand experience of weighing things. Bring a weighing machine into a classroom and let them read the markings. Let them weigh themselves to understand their weights. I hope you've got the idea of weighing and measuring weight enough. Thank you so much.